All right, three nights, three volumes, Blast from the Past. And if you've missed volumes one and two, you can go back and get them. I'm going to put a link to get to them on my video channel, and it'll be in the description down below. And for anybody else that's new checking this out, here's what I'm doing. It's pretty simple. As a former radio DJ and a fan of music, I've grown tired of what is played on the radio all the damn time, over and over. It happens with online music as well, and even on satellite radio. Songs that have charted high, and whenever they play on the radio, you know what they are within the first three notes because you've heard them a million times. So over time, there have been many songs that I remember that blipped on the radar, and then for the most part, I haven't heard them. Or maybe it's been 10 years since I've heard them, or maybe not even heard them at all. And so what I'm doing is I'm doing my best to dig some of those up and then share them here on this new YouTube channel that I've come up with. Now, as a disclaimer, I'm not going to guarantee that what I've selected is something that you haven't heard. I mean, there's always going to be outliers. But my goal is that I hope to. And so maybe I'll succeed at that. And so now, to commemorate number three, volume three, we're going to do two. It's a double barrel blast of country songs. Let's head inside, see what I got. All right, volume number three. It is the double barrel shotgun of country music. And the first one that I've got for you is a guy that made his debut in 2001 with a single called Mrs. Stephen Rudy. This was a top 10 hit on the US Billboard Hot Country Singles charts. And then after being signed to VFR Records, they released his first album, which was called Mark Mcguinn. That was in May of that year, 2001. Initially, the label had planned to release That's a Plan as the album's first single. But, and this is very interesting, after a disc jockey at KPLX in Dallas, Texas, began playing Mrs. Stephen Rudy, another track from the album, other nearby stations soon followed suit. Due to the reaction that the song was getting in the Dallas market, the label released it as Mcguinn's first single and put That's a Plan on the B-side. And if you don't know what a B-side is, look it up. Upon the release of Mrs. Stephen Rudy, Mcguinn was considered a dark horse on the country music scene, due in part to his jazz background and beatnik image, which you're going to see in the video. So these were considered outside the norms of country radio at that time. Remember, at that time. Mrs. Stephen Rudy was a top 10 hit on the Billboard country music charts and the highest selling single on the country single sales charts for five consecutive weeks. But that's not the song that I'm going to play for you tonight. I'm not even going to play That's a Plan, which was eventually, as mentioned, released as the second single. What I've got is the third single that they released, and coincidentally, it charted third highest of the three songs at number 29. Honestly, I don't even remember those other two songs, but I do remember seeing the video I'm about to show you on CMT way back in, I swear it was in the 90s. They say 2001, but I could swear I saw this video and it was in the 1990s. But it caught my eye because of Mark Mcguinn. As we mentioned, he doesn't look at all like he sounds, as you can see right there on the album cover. But I fell in love with this song the first time I heard it. So, here's barrel number one, She Doesn't Dance.
She was in the middle of an empty dance floor, wrapped up in a tall, dark stranger's arms. Didn't see me slipping through the shadows. Sit down at the end of the bar. She was kissing him all over, the way she never kissed me. I knew it was her in a heartbeat, but I knew it couldn't be.
One barrel down, one to go. Kind of sounds like we're drinking whiskey. Next up is an artist who charted 19 songs on the Billboard Hot Country Songs charts, including the number one single, Your Love Amazes Me. And that's from 1994. And if you're a big country fan, you know who I'm talking about already. But following that number one hit, there were six additional top 10 hits that came along. What's in It for Me, You and Only You, Standing on the Edge of Goodbye, I Think About It All the Time, Change My Mind, and She's Taken a Shine. But then something else crazy happened in 1994. John Barry, he began to have terrible headaches. He lost his appetite, and he finally blacked out during a concert. He was then rushed to a hospital on May 9th in 94. This was in Atlanta, and they found a cyst on the third ventricle of his brain. They were able to remove it, and he says that even today he still suffers some short-term memory loss. But being the great guy that he is, he uses humor whenever he occasionally forgets the words to a song, and then even his wife, Robin, she'll use sign language to help assist him with it. Ironically, the same day that he underwent that brain surgery was the same day that he celebrated his first number one single, the aforementioned Your Love Amazes Me. But, as you guys know, that's not what I'm here to play for you. Remember the, you've heard it a million times? I'm sure you've heard Your Love Amazes Me a million times. I am going to play one of the songs that I mentioned. It was the fifth single to chart in the top 10. It reached number 4 in 1994, so it did get played a lot. But remember, Blast from the Past is also about playing something that you may not have heard in a long time. So, Here's John Barry with barrel number two, You and Only You. So there you go. John Barry with his wife Robin doing harmonies there too. You and Only You. It was one of my favorite songs from the 90s. Not just my favorite country song, but one of my favorite songs. And I did own that album. So thanks for checking out Volume 3. Don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell so that you get notified whenever I post something new, which may not always be Blast from the Past stuff. When Backyard Radio comes back, it's going to be exclusively on this iBryant YouTube channel. So until next time, thanks for checking this one out. We'll see you then.